now for more on our special Rossin Report series. Rossin to the rescue. Could you potentially have thousands of dollars collecting dust in your home right this very second?
Or is it just dust in my case? Today, national investigative correspondent Jeff Rossin is here. Hi, Jeff.
You guys like free money?
Yes.
Perfect. Well, then this is a story for you. Believe it or not, experts say the average family has anywhere from $2,500 to $10,000 stashed away. Or if you're a Savannah, like a hoarder, like $30,000. We're not talking about loose change on the couch either. We're talking about the stuff you just have sitting around the house collecting dust that could make you easy money. So what should you be looking for? This morning, we're about to show you.
We're on the hunt with the Altschul family, searching for hidden cash all over their house. In my new book, Rossin to the Rescue, out now, I show you all the ways to save money. Now, I'm showing you how to find it, uncovering valuable items stashed in closets, the garage, even inside your junk drawer. Yeah, there are hidden treasures in here too. You just have to know where to look and what to look for. Here to help, Jackie Denny, managing estate sales for over 20 years and co-founder of Everything But the House. We start in a spot she says is always filled with instant income, the closet.
Jamie, this is where you keep your jewelry.
Yeah.
Jackie came across this piece right here. When was the, do you wear this a lot? How often?
Maybe once or twice. It's been in there forever.
It just sits in the drawer.
It just sits there.
It's the same old story with everybody. What do you find here? What?
Well, Jamie, the good news is this is a early 19th century Italian cameo bracelet. And at market right now, about $175 to $200.
That's pretty good.
Wow, I'll take it.
Would you sell that?
You want to buy it?
Bonus tip, to make the most money on jewelry, Jackie says the luxury consignment website, therealreal.com, is great. Now we're off to the kitchen, and we're shocked at what's in the family junk drawer.
Would you be surprised that you've got about $500 in gift cards in here?
Do I really?
That's like real money.
Jamie,
wow.
100, 100.
108.
108, and a Starbucks card for who knows how much. Two of them actually stuck together.
I don't know where these came from, but I'll take them.
This is real cash.
5 out of 6 of us get gift cards as gifts, and we never use them.
In the garage, we find nearly a dozen bikes and scooters the kids say they never use.
How much can they get for all these extra bikes and scooters?
Well, the nice thing is scooters, bikes are very popular resale items. The average maybe $40 a piece.
That adds up. With
that
this many.
Adds up.
What about the games over
All
there?
All the games over there, not that great of a thing to resell, but what the consignment shops are looking for is Legos, the electronic toys.
We find potential cash in nearly every nook and cranny. Old phones and iPads worth $100, an antique clock worth $500, and Yadro dolls worth $200 a piece. And here's another bonus tip. She says the Shopify app is a great place to sell antiques, but we can't believe the gold mine stashed in Dad's closet, his baseball collection.
I browsed through this book before. It's a compilation of everything from the 1960s, 1970s, some very strong players, about $2,500 for the book.
For this binder, $2,500.
For this binder.
Nice. He also has a Ted Williams signed baseball here.
Recently at auction, one just like that sold for $600.
Wow, I had no idea. This is awesome.
At the end of the day, Jackie adding up the value of everything we found.
Hit it.
$7,850.
Wow.
That's a lot of money.
That's incredible. This is all from stuff that's just laying around the house. What's the message to people at home?
Start looking in the drawers and the closets.
Find the hidden treasures.
Find the hidden
Nice job,
treasures.
Guys. Love that. Here's one more tip. Experts say you should take a close look at the clothes in your closet. Anything you haven't worn in more than a year, sell it. And guess what? Craig Melvin brought in stuff from his closet that he has not worn in a year. Craig, can you take us through this real quick?
Oh, this was a jacket. This is a velvet jacket.
Okay.
Nice? This is my party jacket.
I like it.
So this is when Craig shoots a western
right,
on weekends.
So
if this jacket could tell stories.
These are just some gray slacks. I'm not sure why I haven't worn them.
By the way, I like this suit.
I'll sell it to you right now.
Yeah, perfect. So here's the thing. What sells best, men's suits sell great. For women, it's women's tops, but not the bottoms, because bottoms are often, you know, custom made to, you know, and altered for each particular woman. It's not one size fits all. And the number one resale item,
what?
Shoes.
Purses.
Oh, purses.
Oh, it makes
purses.
Sense.
So if you have handbags lying around, sell those. You make the most money on them.
I do have some baggage.
This has been fun. Jeff, thank you.
Yeah, thanks. Craig, I'll take that
Listen,
suit.
Do you have a book out?
Huh?
Do you have a book out of any sort?
Why don't you mention it?
Yeah, it's called Ross Into the Rescue, and it's now available in stores and online. Check it out.
I love you guys.
I am literally the only person here who has not written a book.
Yeah.
Well, you get on it.
Chop, chop.
Yes.
Hello, Today fans. Thanks for checking out our YouTube channel. Subscribe by clicking that button down there, and click on any of the videos over here to watch the latest interviews, show highlights, and digital exclusives.